I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, torsion. This is the formula for torsion. T divided by Jp is equal to root by R. G theta by L is equal to Q by R. Where T is Newton mm. Tau, maximum shear stress at the outer fiber. Maximum shear stress at outer fiber has to be expressed in terms of Newton mm square. R is the radius of the shaft in terms of mm, length of the shaft in terms of mm, G or C we call as a modulus of rigidity has to express in terms of Newton per mm square. Theta is the angle of twist in terms of radian. Jp the polar moment of inertia has to express in terms of mm raised to 4. For solid shaft, polar moment of inertia will be pi divided by 32 d raised to 4. D is nothing but diameter. For hollow shaft, Jp is equal to pi by 32 into d raised to 4 minus dA raised to 4. Inner diameter and outer diameter. This is the outer diameter and this is the inner diameter. Now, in order to find out the power, the formula is P is equal to 2 pi nt divided by 60,000 kilowatt, where T is nothing but mean torque. It has to express in terms of Newton mm, speed in terms of RPM. This is for finding the diameter with respect to thickness. This is the solid shaft, this is a hollow shaft diagram. Now, one more extra term, that is Q by R, have added here. The Q is indicate what shear stress induced at the radius of R from the center. Shear stress induced at the radius of R, that means this focus over the elementary part, only the small elementary part. Because we are considering an elementary part in order to integrate the entire thing. Then reduce the radius R from the center. For converting degree to radian, we have to go for pi by 180 because theta has to be expressed in terms of radian or in terms of radian to degree, it is 180 by pi. 180 by this is the first problem. What is the length required for a solid steel shaft? First, it is solid one. Data. It is a solid shaft. Diameter is diameter 12 mm. Small d refers to the diameter. So that the cross section at one end can be rotated 90 degrees. Means theta given, theta is equal to 90 degree, we have to express in terms of radian, that is pi by 180, you will get in terms of radian. With respect to other end, without exceeding an allowable shear stress of 70 megapascal, allowable shear stress, that is we indicate tau. Or we call it tau max, which is 70 megapascal. That means 70 newton per mm square. 1 megapascal is nothing but 1 newton per mm square. Assume G is equal to 80 GPa. That is modulus of rigidity. Has to be expressed in terms of newton, 80 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square. Now use the formula. Use this formula. T divided by Jp is equal to tau divided by R is equal to G theta by L. G theta by L. This is the basic formula for torsion. Sometimes they will ask to find out the induced shear stress. Then you can use the Q by R. Now we have to find out the length. For finding the length, you have to go the combinations here. Either you have to go for T divided by Jp or tau divided by R and G theta by L. Now combinations, theta is given, diameter is given, theta is given, shear is given. Now the R can be obtained. R is nothing but d by 2. R is nothing but d by 2. That means the combination of these two is preferred. Tau divided by R is equal to g theta by L. Tau 70. What is R? R is nothing but d by 2. d by 2. What is d here? 12 divided by 2. G 80 into 10 raised to 3. 90 into pi by 180 divided by L. What we have to find out? We have to find out the length here. Now with the help of calculator, you can solve it. 70, 12 divided by 2 is equal to 3 into 3 into 90 into pi divided by 180 alpha x. Shift solve is equal to, you will get the answer here. This one, L is equal to 1077 1.17 mm. In this way you have to solve the problem by using the torsion equation. I am Santosh Gaikwad. Thank you very much.